Every single year, we get a new smartphone with innovative features that leaves every tech enthusiast speechless. But every year, the battery life keeps getting worse. So in collaboration with TubeTechie, we'll be showing you 8 ways you can extend your phone's battery life that you might not have thought about. Links to everything mentioned in this video will be in the description below that like button. And Johnny will now take over to share with you his tip.
Hey, what's up? My name's Johnny. I'm from TubeTechie, and my channel focuses on sharing technology that's going to help you get more done in less time. And I'm here with Grabster to share tips on how you can extend your battery life on your Android device. So the first tip we have for you is closing those pesky background apps. Now, even though you close the apps, you may think it stopped running, but unfortunately, some of the apps still work in the background. For example, Google Docs will actually keep running in your background even though you don't need it. Now, you don't want to go start force closing everything, because if you do that, your phone may not operate the way you want it to. So, the answer to this is to get an app called Greenify. The way Greenify works is it automatically closes and stops running your background apps that you select. The app is free to download, so you don't have to pay anything to help your battery last longer.
Speaking of background apps, I want you to go to your app drawer right now and tell me how many pre-installed apps, or bloatware apps as they call it, are installed on your phone. Count all of them and let me know in the comments below. Let's see whose phone has the most bloatware installed. Thankfully, I use a phone with Android 1, so I only got one app that is actually quite useful. So 90% of all these apps are completely useless. There is a higher chance that you never even open them. These apps run in the background and are occupying storage on your phone for no reason. These apps can be uninstalled, but they can be disabled. To disable them, go to the app's info page and tap disable app. If you really want to uninstall these bloatware apps from your phone, I will leave a link to a safe way to uninstall them without root in the description below.
So tip number 3 is changing your animation speeds on your Android device. Now, I'm sure you already know about speeding up your phone by lowering the animation scales in the developer options. Now, there's an app called System UI Tuner, which will help you decrease scales even further for all your animations. Now, with this app, you can disable your animations completely, or you can actually just set it to a lower number. I actually have mine set to 0.3 and it works out quite well. Now, on an added note, you do need to use a PC or have root access in order to use this app on your Android phone.
Speaking of without root, recently I made a video about how you can increase gaming performance by lowering your phone's screen resolution. Doing a little more research, I found that it not only increases your phone's performance, it also increases your phone's battery life. So if you can live with slightly larger icons, I would highly recommend checking that video out. I will leave a link to it in the card above and in the description. Samsung phones already has this feature built into its settings. If you keep it at the lowest setting, you can save a lot of battery.
Tip number 5 is use dark themed apps on your OLED phones. You may already know this, but for OLED screens, the black portions are actually lights that aren't lit up. So if you choose a black theme or a dark theme, then effectively you're saving energy by not lighting up all the lights on your screen. So my tip is to use all dark themes on all the apps that you use. It'll save up to 50% on your battery life, and it'll save your eyes in the long run. And if you really want to take it up a notch, you can check out the AMOLED theme setup tutorial and give your phone a true black makeover.
Next, I'm going to share with you a rule that I came up with myself called the 14 days rule. Trademark. Go to your Play Store install library and sort it by last used. Scroll down and uninstall all apps that haven't been used since the last 2 weeks. You'd be surprised how many unnecessary apps you have installed on your phone that you won't even remember installing. Obviously, that doesn't include apps that doesn't require your attention or their main function is to run in the background like Sesame Search, but you do need them. Doing this every 2 weeks can not only save battery, because as TubeTechie mentioned, these apps run in the background, it can boost up overall phone performance and free up a lot of storage space.
Tip number 7 is cleaning up those unnecessary files that are left behind by apps that bog down your battery life. Now, what you don't know is a lot of apps install a lot of extra files in your cache to help speed up the app's performance. Now, what this does though is it actually uses more processing power and therefore more battery life from your phone. The best way to take care of these pesky cached files is to use an app called SDMade or CCleaner. It's one of the first apps I install when I get my Android device. So SDMade actually works a little different than CCleaner. Instead of just cleaning up the apps, it actually cleans up all the cached files that are left behind when you uninstall apps. Because again, those leftover files are going to end up eating up some of your battery life.
And last but not least, avoid all these battery saver, battery booster, charger type apps as much as you can. These apps claim to boost your battery, but in fact, they consume more of your battery by showing you ads, add extra overlays on your screen, and God knows what else. From personal experience, these apps make zero impact on your battery. The only app that really works is the one TubeTechy mentioned, and that is Greenify. And that concludes our 8 ways of saving battery life of your Android phone. Make sure you check out TubeTechy because we did another video on his channel where we share with you some great Photoshop tips that you might not know about. Link to his channel will be in the description below. If you'd like to see more videos like this every week, subscribe and tap that bell so you don't miss any future videos. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Peace out.